Hello everybody and welcome to our channel. Today we'll be taking a look at coverage creation. In this series, we'll be creating a coverage from scratch and going over best practices for the coverage creation process. There's too much to cover here to put this all in one video, so I've broken it up into sections to keep the content relevant to you. If you're familiar with tower, system, and RX settings, you can skip to part 2 for the transmitter settings. If you're familiar with transmitter settings, skip to part 3 for overlay and coverage arrays. Let's go ahead and get started by opening up a new coverage. The accuracy of your data is extremely important here, so we recommend that you base each coverage map on the actual equipment you're using. That being said, it's a good idea to have the datasheet for your equipment handy before you begin this process. The first thing you're going to want to do is select your tower site. The number will populate based on what you put in your site settings, but you can change it if necessary. Moving on to system settings now. RX threshold determines where the coverage is shown during overlay creation. We suggest you set this value to the minimum signal you require during an install. -70 is sort of decent, so we're going to go ahead and keep it that way. Required reliability is a bit of a fudge factor setting. It pads your results by creating additional statistical loss to get a more reliable link. For point to multipoint setups, you'll want to set this around 70 to 80%. Use LAN cover tells the site whether or not to take your LAN cover settings into account in the calculations. The setting below this is where you define which LAN cover settings you prefer to use. If you create a custom setting and would like to apply it, you would do that here. Two rays are used for multipath calculations. Most WISPs use radios that can't do this, so the option is turned off by default. If you have a system that can use it, then you may want to turn this value on. The View Shed option sets all LAN cover density values to 10,000. This means that as soon as the signal attempts to go through any type of LAN cover, it'll result in a loss so great that the signal won't go through it. What makes this different than other systems is that the views held here actually take into account LAN cover values. If you elect to do the checkbox for LTE coverage, basically what it does is it converts RSSI to RSRP for LTE signal strength. Checking the data images box gives you access to a couple of different overlays on your coverage map. This feature is covered in more detail from our LAN cover tutorial. Average client height is the height that you would normally install a client antenna. We recommend using a modest to low value here. A height of 5 to 10 feet is fairly conservative, and it would not show coverage where there is none. If you won't have much, if any, client height during installation, then you can set this value to 0. There's one major factor when you're looking at client average antenna gain. If you're looking to create a map with the maximum coverage area, you're going to need to enter the largest receiving radio's values here. If you want to standardize based on the normal radio you would use and not the largest, your coverage is going to be a little bit smaller. It's really more of a technical decision on what you want your map to show. RX line loss is the average loss you have when setting up a client radio on your network. For most situations, 0.5 is enough, unless your equipment is installed with a significant amount of cable between the radio and the antenna. If this is the case, you're going to need to use the specifications of the cable to determine how much loss you have. If you found this video helpful, please like and subscribe. That is all I have for now, guys, but I will see you for the next one.